Hello, hello, hello. Well, I am here to talk to you today about a four-letter word in business: risk. Who needs it? It can be very risky to start your own creative business with all the questions that are swirling around through your mind. Is anybody going to buy your stuff? Is anybody going to see your stuff? Are you even good enough to be selling your own stuff? Are you going to lose money? Are you going to starve? All of these questions. We're going to talk about all of these things today. But before we do, hello, brave one. And thank you for joining me live today. And if you are watching in the replay, I invite you to play along with me, ask questions, let me know what you're thinking, and I will be sure to answer you later. And hey, if you think what I'm talking about today might be helpful for someone that you know, then I want you to spread this like your favorite jam amongst your peeps. If you're here with me live, then give me a hey, give me a shout out, let me know that you're here so I can say hello to you personally, and acknowledge your presence. But let's get to it. Let's talk about what we're talking about today. Oh, before you do, I forgot to tell you, if you are new here and you don't know who I am, my name is Ella Glasgow. I am known as the Dream Igniter, and I help creative entrepreneurs just like you make real money in their creative business, even if they've got kids, no resources, and no clue where to start. And we're going to talk about that today. If there's anything that I'm saying today to you that you are just like, oh my gosh, that is fire, then give me a hashtag, this is fire, and let me know what it is that lit you up today. So here's the question: is starting a creative business really more risky than starting any other business? I've heard people say many times, oh, creatives, they starve. And I can't do that for real. And I do hear this often because I still work with young creatives, that haven't necessarily made the decision yet as to whether or not they're going to be making that their livelihood. But I know that the stigma is still out there that it's not a real career path to be a creative. And I'm here to let you know that that is not true. I and many others are making a living creatively. And today I want to talk to you about what risk really means and how I believe that when it comes to risk, there really is a mindset that has to shift when it comes to thinking about risk and your creative business. The general mindset, like I said, is that it's risky and that creatives will starve. And it's time for us to change our languaging around business and creativity in general and take it to the real crux of the matter. And if you've been with me before, then you know that I love a good definition. So, I want to give you the definition, the Merriam-Webster definition of risk. Here it is. Okay, just bear with me because it might be scary. Hold on. Risk, possibility of loss or injury, peril, someone or something that creates or suggests a hazard, a chance of loss or the perils to the subject matter of an insurance contract, also the degree of probability of such loss, a person or thing that is specified ha that is specified hazard to an insurer, an insured insurance hazard from a specified cause or source, the chance that an investment with a stock or commodity will lose value. I mean, when you hear the definition of risk, it is scary. Maybe we shouldn't be doing this. But I mean, here's the thing. This is the only part that your friends and your family are focused on when that business is risky. The fear. That's the only part that people who have never done it before, or maybe they've done it and the only thing they've experienced is failure and now they're bitter about it. That's the only part that they focus on. Instead of finding a new way to look at risk and help you to mitigate it better for yourself and for your business. I want you to know that creative business is thriving and you are taking a part in it every single day. That graphic design that's at your local coffee shop was most likely created by a creative. The songs that you bought and paid for and blast on your phone were created by a creative, and they were not free to you, and they did not do it for free. Those are just some examples, and it may be really hard for you to grasp it at your particular level. So what I would love to do right now is for us to dig a little bit deeper into the mindset of risk. There are a lot of things that we could talk about, but I have four that I want to talk with you about today that I feel get the most overlooked. So the first one is strategic risk. When we don't have a full understanding of what it is that we're getting into, and we neglect to plan that how we'll make that thing happen, then we run the risk of failure because we never planned for the possibilities of what could or could not happen. Without a plan, others fail to see how any of what you're dreaming is possible, and their doubt seeps into your mind, which in turn has you believing that what you're dreaming is not possible. I want to remind you that everything that you see around you, whether it be the computer that you work on, the phone that you might be watching me on, the very platform that we're doing this on, was all a part of someone's creative dream. It all starts here. But if you allow those doubts and negative thoughts to seep into your mind and cloud that vision, it becomes impossible. And the business that you dream about, the thing that you dream about making money with, does suddenly become impossible. So we must plan. We must strategize. We must have a way for us to get from where we're sitting right now to where it is that we dream of being. Number two, operational risk. Day-to-day operations at a regular job are pretty much laid out for you. You can punch in, you clock out, you follow the checklist that they've given you. Everyone knows what to expect, from the customers to you. We all know what to expect when we go into Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A around the world, doesn't matter where you go. You know what to expect when you walk in. You know how they're going to be, how they're going to operate, how quick it's going to take, or how long it's going to take. And you are okay with that. But the risk runs deep when we fail to set up these same boundaries in our new business. This is something that creatives have a hard time thinking about, and that's the operational processes. The expectations that we need to set for the people that want to take part in the service that we provide. You have to take the time to assess your own boundaries, your boundaries on spending, your boundaries on time, your boundaries on your personal space. This can be the hardest part for you as a new creative business owner, and when you haven't taken the time to assess what's going to work best for your life and your schedule. This is the mindset shift that has to happen. You have to allow yourself to create those boundaries and set up those expectations, not just for your clients, but for yourself. How are you going to run your day-to-day operations to make sure that your business keeps moving forward? It's the same as any other larger business, except it's just you on a much smaller scale. You have to have time constraints, and you need to acknowledge where you are, and you need a clear strategy on how to make your new business work for you. Not the way Chick-fil-A runs their business, what works for you and the where you are right now. The third risk is financial risk, and this one can often be the scariest for people, because there is a real possibility of losing money. Nobody wants to lose money. It's scary, and it's possible in a new creative business that's started without a strategic plan. You have to be willing to assess where you are financially. This is where most of the businesses I see messing up get messed up right out of the gate. They've gone to some event, some convention, and at that event, they have all of these tools and resources that they've said that you need. However, you have not taken the time to assess what you do really need right now because you haven't created a strategic plan. And so you run the risk of losing money using tools that you're not ready for. You have to know where you are right now and assess where you are right now, financially, time-wise, personally. Where are you? What makes sense for you right now? Does it make sense for you to grab that $300 a month tool to manage your business when you're just starting out and you may not necessarily have the income coming in to keep up with a $300 a month tool? You have to think about those things when it comes to risk. When we don't look at those particular sides of it, that's when we start to slide downhill. And the last one, number four, is reputational risk. And this one may be the biggest. It's a scary one because the possibility of the most important, it's possibly the most important one to assess about yourself. The question gets asked in your mind, what are people going to think if I fail? What will my family think if I fail? What will my friends think if I fail? I saw Joe down the street try to start something and he failed and it was horrible. But you have to ask yourself, what was going on with Joe or any other person who you've seen start a business and not exactly make it? I want you to know that failure is inevitable. You're going to fail at some part, at some point. However, it's what you do with that failure that changes the game. That is the piece that changes the game for every single business that you partake in. I talked about Chick-fil-A today. Chick-fil-A is lovely and I love it. It's failed. They had some failures. They've had some public ones. And they've had some ones that we probably have never even heard about. Probably the biggest creative for you to be able to think about who had huge failures and yet bounced back from them is Walt Disney. He's my favorite creative to really look at and see how much he pushed through to still make what we know today as the Disney Empire. Without his willingness to move through creative risk, we would not have Disney World. We would not have all of our beloved movies. We wouldn't have our favorite Mickey Mouse. So I encourage you today to flip the script on all of these pieces that we've talked about today. Those four pieces are strategic risk, operational risk, financial risk, and reputational risk. Where can you change your mindset when it comes to those particular things, when it comes to the business that you have been dreaming about starting? Today, if you have been thinking about this and this is striking fire of desire in you and you're realizing, oh man, I have not really looked at my business in a way that would allow me to mitigate the risk that I've imagined there would be in my business and has caused me to sit back and not launch it. If that's you, I want to offer you some time to speak with you. And I'm going to make this really easy. Just send me a private message. Just send me a private message. Let me know what's going on. What have you been thinking about? Where have you been stuck? And let's talk about how you can be a part of the revolution that I am creating with providing resources for creatives in a way that is accessible to you, where you are right now, within your budget right now. Give me a call or send me a little message and we'll talk about it. Let's talk about where you are. Let's talk about the risks and the thoughts and the things that maybe you haven't thought about to help you get from point A, where you are right now, to where you dream to be. I would love to help you with that. That is all I have for you today. Before we go, I will just give a little quick recap. We've talked about that four-letter word, risk. It's a scary one when it comes to business, but if you will flip the script on that mindset and understand how to make all of these things work in your favor so that your business is not a risk to you. First one, strategic risk. understanding that you must have a plan. You must have a plan of action and understand what's going on with your business and how you can make it work, the steps that you need to take it from your brain into reality. Number two, operational risk. What are the day-to-day operations? What are the things that you need to do every day in your business to keep it moving forward? Every single business on the planet has day-to-day operations, and the job that you're punching into, you know exactly what is expected of you and what it is that you need to do. In your own business, you need to lay out those expectations for yourself. Number three, financial risk. Losing money in a new business really is a possibility, especially when you haven't taken into consideration your own financial situation and you are only going off of what everyone else is telling you that you need to buy that has no relevancy to where you are right now. Number four, reputational risk. Possibly the scariest one of all. What do people think if I fail at this thing? Being able to move past that mindset and understanding that you have something very valuable to give to the world. Failure will happen, but what you do with it will determine how successful you are in your business. I have had such a great time with you today. Thank you so much for joining me. I am Ella Glasgow, and I am on a mission to help creative entrepreneurs just like you get out of overwhelm so you have a clear vision, you know the steps that you need to take, and have the confidence to make your dream your reality while making a significant income. Thank you so much. Remember, brave one, you don't have to be brave alone. I will see you next time.